Just wanted to do a little introduction or some practice on unit conversions, since unit conversions are typically one of the simplest mistakes to make on a test problem or a homework problem, and it's something you just need to practice and get used to and comfortable with so that you don't make those mistakes. So I got a couple, three examples I wanted to go through and just kind of talk about a setup. And once you get comfortable doing this kind of setup, and more of it becomes in your head or on paper, not necessarily in this strategy, but at least to start, this is kind of the way that's suggested. And that is, if we are going in this case from, say, 1 cup, and we want to go to a certain amount of moles of water, we have to be able to figure out what conversion factors we need and what those are so that we can convert from that 1 cup of water to those moles of water. And so what we typically do is we'll draw something that looks like this, with the line in the middle and units on both the top and the bottom, and then start putting our conversion factors in between. So you have to have an approach, and I just so happen to know that we can go from a volume to a mass using density, and to go from a mass to moles using the molecular weight. So I'll go ahead and show you how to go about that, and just in terms of the setup, how you would approach it. There are a couple different conversion factors you could use for density. The one I could recall off the top of my head is that there is 1 gram of water per 1 milliliter of water. So that makes it kind of easy to just go from there. And then you can memorize or look up some other volume conversions. For instance, if you cook a lot, hopefully you'll know that in terms of cups and milliliters, that there are 240 milliliters per cup. And so it's important that you notice which side, the top or the bottom, that we're putting these units. We want the cup on the bottom so that we could cross those off. And the same thing here, we want the milliliters of water on the top so we could cross those off. So now we have grams of water. So to go from grams to moles, we could use the molecular weight. And since we want grams to cancel, we're going to put grams on the bottom. So how many grams of water are per mole of water? Well, you could look that up or calculate it, and it should be 18 grams. And so now we could cross out our grams of water, and we're left with moles. And so the only thing you have left to do is make these multiplications, where you have 240 over 18, and that is going to give you the amount of moles of water. And in this case, it comes out to about 13.3 moles of water. So let's try another one. Here's a question for you, and something I recall from when I was younger, was whether or not you think you could outrun an alligator that could go up to 20 miles per hour if you can cover a 40-yard dash in 5 seconds. Now, there are obviously a lot faster people out there, but relatively, 5 seconds and 40 yards isn't too far off. So the way we would start this is write our 40 yards in 5 seconds, because that's our velocity that we want to compare with the velocity of an alligator. We're going to continue this line across, and we want to get to miles per hour. So now this is going to help us see what conversion factors we're going to use. So I'm going to go ahead and tell you to pause at this point and try to fill this in and calculate what your speed in miles per hour is. Now, you could either choose to go with yards or seconds to start with. Doesn't really matter. First thing that comes to my mind is how to get rid of the seconds. So we know that there's 3,600 seconds in 1 hour. That's going to cross those off. We have our hour, so now we got to go from yards to miles. You could probably look something up, or if you know the conversion from yards to miles, use that. I do know that there are 3 feet per 1 yard, and that there are 5,280 feet per 1 mile. So now you can see that the feet are canceling, the yards are canceling, and we have our miles per hour. So the only thing left to do is multiply the top numbers, divide by the bottom numbers, and you should see that this comes out to 16.4 miles per hour, meaning you'd probably be lunch. A final question, which is something that you may come across in your travels or if you're curious. But the question asks whether or not it's cheaper to drive in the US with an average 20 miles to the gallon right now, or in Germany, where the average is about 6 liters per 100 kilometers, and that's kind of how they report it over there. So you got a couple different conversions you have to make, and there's some information that's not given that you'd probably have to be resourceful enough to look up. So how do we go about this? Well, we need to figure out some way to compare these two to each other. So let's do it in two ways. Let's compare how much it costs to drive a mile in each country, and also how much it costs per gallon of gasoline. All right, so we'll start with the US because that's already in the units that we're kind of talking about. And if we go 20 miles to 1 gallon of gasoline, what unit conversion would get us towards miles to dollars? Well, we have to convert the dollars and gallons, and so we'll say that 1 gallon probably costs us about $3. And so this conversion should yield about 6.67 miles to the dollar, which is also going to be about 15 cents per mile. And we already have our price per gallon since that's what we've looked up. So now we just have to convert Germany's system over. So let's start with the 6 liters per 100 kilometers. And I'll draw my single dimensional equation. And we want to get to dollars per mile. So let's start with the kilometers. We know that there's 1.6 kilometers per 1 mile. That will give us our mile and cancel out kilometers. So now all we have to do is get to our prices. We know that the price of gasoline, if you look it up right now, is about 1 euro per liter. And there's about $1.5 per 1 euro. And these may not be that accurate depending on when you look at this. But if we do this calculation, we'll see that it's about 14 cents per mile. Well, that's really not that different from what we see here. Well, per mile, it's not, but if we wanted to check to see what it was on a volume basis, 1 euro over 1 liter, using our dimensional equation, 3.78 liters per 1 gallon. And then again, the price conversion of $1.50 per euro. And if you calculate this out, what you'll see is that the price of gas is about $5.7 per gallon. So what's this say? Well, although distance-wise it doesn't cost less, the reason for that is that the cars in Germany are just getting better gas mileage on average than the cars over here in the US.